helping an older sibling deal with a new baby. Congratulations, because if you're watching this video, you've either just had a new baby or you're about to have a new baby or you've got a, you know, 3-month-old. Anyway, congratulations. That is what we're talking about very soon, how to help older siblings deal with a new baby. Older siblings dealing with a new baby. I have done this a few times, and what I've really seen works the best is when you make your child that this is their baby. That means that sometimes you let them hold them, even if they have a runny nose, you try to like put them as far away as possible and wipe their nose. Sometimes you let them hold them when you feel like they don't need to hold them so much. Sometimes you let them do things that, you know, you feel like you could do yourself, just stay away from the baby. But when you make this baby into your child's baby, it's a totally different ball game, because then it's their baby, their project, things that they get to do with the baby. It's their privilege to have a new baby, as opposed to this baby is taking your mother away from you right now, and you should kindly step aside and just wait in line. It's a very different feeling. So when it's, you know, who's gonna burp the baby? And then you let your child burp the baby. Sometimes it's, you know, getting the wipes for the baby. Sometimes it's picking out the outfit for the baby or picking which blankie he's gonna get to use. The other thing is that's so, so important. Right now I've just been talking about like, sounds like little kids, but even with older kids, you know, when you've got like a 5-year-old, a 7-year-old, a 9-year-old, an 11-year-old, allow them to do more with the baby than your natural instinct is to, hold on to this baby for dear life. Don't let them anywhere near it. Allow them to do more. I mean, be safe, obviously. Let your little kid hold the baby when they're in the middle of a large bed with lots of pillows around them. Be safe, but let them do it. The same goes for a bit of an older child, okay? So you're not only letting them hold the baby and walk around taking care of the baby, but making decisions for the baby, picking out their clothing, anything that involves things that they want to initiate being part of. I just do it. Let them, you don't let go of the control. This works especially when you have teenagers. Let them make the decisions. What does it matter to you? Let them make the decisions. Let them pick the outfits. Let them, help pick a name even. Let your children be part of the process of having this baby, because then they feel like it's their baby, as opposed to the baby being a competition for your love. The second thing, which I think you know I'm going to say, is watch the competition for your love. You really have to make sure that your child is getting lots of attention from you, because this is a vulnerable time for them. You know, like you feel like, okay, I need a few weeks to, you know, recover. And while your job may say you've got 6 to 8 weeks, no problem, stay home and recover, you don't have that at home. Your children need you just as much as they did any other day. So even if you don't need to do the physical work of, you know, doing all the things to take care of them, have someone else help you with that, give them the emotional attention. Give them time when you're not with the baby, when your baby goes to the crib or someone else is taking the baby, and you are giving undivided individual attention and love to your child, so that they know that they are the most important thing to you. And the baby is an addition to the family. So many parents, they like, you know, they've got kids or they've got a child and then they have a new baby and like full focus on that new child, and everyone else just needs to wait a little. Not because they're trying to, it's just by default. Babies take a lot of time and energy. Babies are exciting, they're very cute, and they take a lot of energy. So try to, as much as possible, especially if you're seeing that your child is getting a little bit antsy or they're getting jealous or they're like tired of you with the baby all the time, try as much as possible to put the baby away a little bit. And when you put the baby away a little bit, I'm saying in the crib with the nanny, with the babysitter, with your sister, then concentrate on your child. Spend so much time and energy. Talk to your child about anything except for the baby. And also the baby if that's what they want to talk about. But make sure that you've got the undivided individual time with your child. That goes for you. That goes for dad. That anybody that your child normally has lots of time and attention, make sure they're still getting that, okay? So like when the grandparents or aunts and uncles come over to see the new baby, ask them, just like send them a little text or a whisper in the ear, a little birdie should tell them. First thing when you walk in the door, give attention to the older child. Make them feel special. Make them feel like you have a new sibling. You are a big brother. And give them tons of time and energy and attention. Then happen to notice the baby. Because your child will react to having this new baby. We're talking about the first days and we're talking about long term. The way you help them react to it. If this baby is their baby and they're not losing anything from having that baby, they still have all the time and attention and love from you, then that baby is, it's all gain. Hey, I got a fun doll to play with and it's so cute. It's going to smile with me and I like my baby. As opposed to the baby takes up all mom's time and I don't really want that baby around. And you know what? We're miracle makers, you know what I'm saying? We can multitask. You can nurse the baby and still be reading your child a story. You can cuddle, you know, the baby who's nursing and your other child in bed at the same time. There's so many ways that you can multitask. And in addition to spending individual time. So yeah, babies take a lot of time. They take a lot of energy. But if you can manage this, then you're going to see that the older sibling is not going to feel the jealousy. And yes, you know, older siblings feel the jealousy just as much as little ones. You know, so whether you're talking about a 16-month-old, a 3-year-old, a 5-year-old, or a 12-year-old, they can all feel the jealousy. So make sure to rest up. Congratulations, and really try to give that special time and attention to your child so they don't start feeling that jealousy of the younger sibling.